Hello everyone, welcome to the course on electronic devices module 5. We'll be studying about the fabrication in this particular lecture. The process of fabrication for all the devices such as the diodes, BJTs and the FETs are all similar with slight modification in the process. All the integrated circuits are nowadays built using FETs. Earlier BJTs were being used, but nowadays they use FETs because of several advantages over the BJTs. CMOS integrated circuits are usually fabricated on a thin circular slice of silicon called a wafer. This is the circular slice of a silicon. This is called the wafer. And each wafer contains several hundreds of thousands of chips or the die. You can see over here the square part in this wafer is a chip. So there are hundreds and thousands of chips formed or developed from this circular wafer. So you can see this square part, it's a chip. This forms a chip. This is the top view of that particular chip, and this is the side view of the chip. So the thickness of this chip is usually less than 1 mm, and the size, the diameter of the wafer is typically from 100 mm to 300 mm, and larger the wafer size, more number of ICs or the dies can be fabricated. So this is a different size or the diameter of the wafer. So this is 150 mm wafer, almost equal to 6-inch wafer. This is 200 mm dia wafer, almost a size of 8-inch wafer, and the latest one is the 300 mm dia wafer. It's a pure silicon wafer. It's about 12-inch. So the larger the wafer size, more number of chips can be developed from that. The latest technology, they use this 300 diameter wafer or the 12-inch wafer. So you can see, as I have told, several thousands of dies can be created, developed from each wafer. So this is one chip. The size of this is the thickness of this is less than 1 mm. The size is about 0.4 mm to 0.5 mm depending upon what type of circuit is being developed. Is usually packaged on a plastic packaging. You might have already seen the IC's thick package. This is plastic packaging over here. A cover on the top usually keeps the chip for being exposed to light or any accidental damage. So this entire part will be covered using a cover. This chip's electrical signals are transmitted to the pins of the package through the wire. So across this IC, there are pins. It's a 40-pin IC. So across this IC, there are pins which are electrically connected to this chip through wires. So before going in detail of the cross-section of views, cross-section view of the ICs, you have to understand the difference between the top view and the cross-section view. So let us take a simple example of a cake or a pastry, or we call it as a pie. So if you take the pie, here you can see this is the top view of the pie, where there is cream, where you can see some choco chips over here. So this is the top view. You don't know what is there inside this. So now if you just cut it right here at the, if you just cut it into half, you can see the side view of the pie. Here you can see the crust, which is the base. Then you can see little cream over here. Then you can see few nuts. And then above this again a cream or caramel or some choco pieces or the choco chips on the cake. So side view gives more information about the base, in between contents and all. So this is called the cross section view and of the layout, and this is called the top view of the layout. Similarly, we'll be having this for the integrated circuit. So this is the cross-section view of the inverter IC. So if the inverter IC is sliced into half, and from the sides if you see the layout, so this is the internal diagram of the inverter. We have, this is circuit diagram. Here at the bottom you can see the circuit diagram. We have the PMOS transistor. As you all know, it's an FET, so it has three terminals: a drain, source and the gate terminal. So source terminal is connected to VDD and a drain terminal is connected to the drain terminal of the NMOS transistor. So here you have the NMOS transistor. Gate terminals are interconnected of the PMOS and the NMOS to the input A. The drain terminals are interconnected of the PMOS and the NMOS to the output Y, and source terminal of the NMOS is grounded over here, and the source terminal of the PMOS is grounded. So more detail about the circuitry we'll be studying later. So right now for your understanding, so this is the PMOS transistor, and over here it is the NMOS transistor. Similar like the pi, we have the base, that is the p substrate, or you call it as a crust, or the base of the integrated circuit, it's a p substrate. Then you have the PMOS transistor, the n well of the PMOS transistor. Then we have p plus drain and source terminals. So here you can see the drain terminal and then the source terminal of the PMOS transistor. Then in the NMOS side we have the base, that is the p substrate, and then n plus source and the drain terminals. Then this is the polysilicon over here which is interconnected. So we have the polysilicon over the PMOS transistor, so it's written over here gate. Similarly over here we have gate of the NMOS transistor. So this gate terminal and this gate terminal of the PMOS are interconnected using a metal wire. So here you can see the gate, this gate and this gate will be interconnected using a metal wire, and then other connections will be done. Then we have the fourth terminal, that is the body right at the center, which is not shown over here in the schematic diagram. Right at the center we have the fourth terminal, which is called the body. The body of the PMOS transistor is connected to VDD and the body of the NMOS transistor is connected to ground. So here you can see the source terminal and the body is interconnected to the VDD. Similarly, the body and the source terminal of the NMOS transistor is interconnected to the ground. So here you can see grounded using a metal. So this blue is a metal, and then we have the polysilicon. This black one is a polysilicon. Then we have the P diffusion, N diffusion and SiO2 layer. So there are several steps or the processes involved during this fabrication. So let us check the steps in brief. So these are the fabrication steps of the inverter IC. We'll just go in brief about this fabrication steps, because the main thing we have to learn over here are the fabrication process. There are different fabrication process involved during the fabrication of IC. So we have to try to understand the fabrication process. So going through the steps of the fabrication, you know, we have already seen in the previous slide that there's a P substrate. Actually the base material is the wafer, the silicon wafer. P impurities are doped to form the P substrate. Then over this we have a silicon dioxide. So this is done by thermal oxidation. This is one of the process of fabrication, thermal oxidation. Then we have a layer of photoresist over this. Then photoresist is being etched off from the surface. So this is a second method or the second process, etching. We have oxidation, thermal oxidation, where silicon dioxide layer is placed on the surface. Then we have etching of the photoresist. Then we have etching of the silicon dioxide. This is again a process, etching. Then we have diffusion of the N well or the N impurities to form the N well. So diffusion is one of the process of fabrication. Then we have polysilicon being placed on the entire surface. So the process of placing the polysilicon on the entire surface is called chemical vapor deposition. Then using hydrofluoric acid, the photoresist is being removed from certain area, and then it is just left out at a particular area to form the gate terminal. So the chemical vapor deposition or CVD is one of the process. Then SiO2 is layer is placed on the entire surface, and then again it is etched off. So this etching is done selectively using photolithography or a mask. The process called as photolithography, or we have the mask developed from this photolithography process. So photolithography is another process. Then you have diffusion. So nowadays they use ion implantation instead of diffusion. So ion implantation is one of the method of diffusing the impurities, the p-type or the n-type impurity into the substrate material. So we have the p-mos transistor and then the n-mos transistor. So finally we have the inverter. We have metal being placed on the surfaces wherever we need. So here you can see the gate terminal will be connected using a metal. Then we have the drain terminal interconnected to form the input, and the source terminal of the NMOS grounded, source terminal of the PMOS is grounded. So this is metallization. This is another process. So if we list down the different steps which are being used during the fabrication, they are thermal oxidation, then you have diffusion, then you have ion implantation, then photolithography, chemical vapor deposition, and one more process is called the thermal processing or the rapid thermal processing. So all these processes we have to study in detail. Basically these processes are there in your syllabus to be studied. So these are the references. Thank you.